Vårt medium har inte fått någon som helst förhandsinformation om fallet. Men redan i bilen känner Terry av en kvinna.
It was like a curtain parted.
Yeah.
And there she was. I've never had that happen before. She's behind the curtain.
She, it's a woman.
It's a woman, yeah. She's troubled about someone else or someone in the family.
Plötsligt får Terry även kontakt med en man.
Now we've got a man here. Mm-hmm. Whatever the feeling I have, the woman's come to help the man. It's almost as if she's taking care of him. We kind of been brought in, it would seem, to help her take this man to the other side.
Hej!
Kul att träffa dig.
Kul att träffa dig. Hej, Eva.
Stefan.
Kul att träffa dig. Okay. I want to begin by saying this to you both. When I came into the entrance, when I came into the house, there was this lady waiting for me, down by the entrance. And a very kind and a very loving lady. And she said to me, I've been waiting for you. And she had so much love and so much compassion. It's the kind of love and compassion a family member has. But she tells me that the reason she has been causing a little disturbance there, and you've had some activity, she came to help you. Because she came to collect a man who passed but didn't want to leave this life. So we're going to work with that at the moment, okay? I just want to let this lady show me, and then I'm going to start talking as she shows me around, okay? Ah, this is where she wants to take me first. Into the kitchen. You can be cooking your food. And you feel that presence. Do you recognize that?
Yes.
And you do not like to have anyone interfering with you when you're cooking food. Du har sagt, hon vill bli helt galen när hon lagar mat. And so she'd been teasing you.
När vi kommer hem så känner vi att det luktar mat.
I've never had a spirit lady saying this to me before. I've taken over here, young man, and I'm glad she's calling me a young man because that doesn't happen often these days. But if she's saying, if you think you can come into this house and take over, you can forget it. Because that's how she was when she was in life. She's saying, I like to have fun here. I like to be the boss when I was here. But she couldn't say goodbye to you. She didn't have time.
Så känner Terry av mannen vid entrén igen.
Would you understand a man who was either very sick or passed very, very quickly, connected with your family?
Yes.
And, you know, it was in many ways heartbreaking for you. Because you didn't have any final contact, you didn't get to say goodbye. Understand?
Yes.
He's the guy she's come to help. It was tragic, it was sudden. I can't breathe, I feel as if I'm being crushed, there's blood. And then I see waiting for help to come, but I was stuck and no one came, it was too late. He shows me his face. What beautiful eyes. Yeah, that's a very special eyes. Very special. When he was here, he wasn't the most pleasant person in the world.
Yes, I understand.
He didn't always think so much about other people or yes. About what they need or what they wanted. It was that he could at times be kind of like he thought too much about himself and what he needed. Do you understand?
Yes. I understand.
I'm doing it in the politest way I can. And I'll say it to you like that, okay? And then can he do something which you might not like, but can he do it? It's okay, it's not bad, it's okay. It's
yes.
And then he says, skull.
No.
You understand?
Yes.
But he was very disappointed when he got to the other side. Det finns ingen systembolaget. Can he make a joke? Because he was quite a joker, this guy, too.
Yes.
I asked the spirit world that, if it would be okay if next time someone visited my grave that they didn't bring flowers, that they brought a bottle of whiskey. And they said, no. But he wants to tell you that since he's been over there, he started to work with that problem.
Good.
Why didn't I use the intelligence God gave me? Because this man could have been anything.
Yes, I know.
He was so clever, technically, with his mind or whatever. But there was only one way to live his life, and one that was his way. And everybody around him had to live his life his way. Whatever this man was when he was here, he comes back today not just with negativity, he's coming back with love. And Hans there, älskling, förlåt mig. Förlåt mig. By the way, he likes you. He's very happy that you two are together. But one of the reasons he came back to this house, because he's been causing some of the disturbance here too. If he had not come back and connected with you again and asked to be forgiven, and say, forlot me, he couldn't have gone over, continued over there.
Yes, sir.
And he, you know what brought him back? The prayers that you offered for him. Mm. You ask God to be kind to him. Understand?
Yes.
And you ask God to forgive him.
Yes.
You actually did that. And when you offered those prayers, it didn't come just from your mind, it came from your heart. Because you're a good person. Say hello to all the family for me. You understand? Give them my love.
Terry har fått kontakt med en kvinna och en man som båda verkar vara kopplade till Eva. Men han är långt ifrån klar med sitt besök i Östersund. Mer om det efter pausen. I sovrummet får Terry kontakt med ytterligare en kvinna som verkar höra till Stefan.
Would you understand, one second, would you understand a lady passing very quickly to a really sweet, loving lady, absolutely a beautiful human being.
Mm.
Yes. And she just says, I closed my eyes and I just went. I didn't say goodbye. And one of the reasons she's come for you, Stefan, is because this is what she wants to do.
Okay.
Touch your heart. Yeah. And she's going to say it like this. In many ways, I'm still like a mama to you. You understand?
Yeah.
And I've come to you because you have been asking the spirit world if this is anything real in any of this. You understand?
Yes, I have.
Because you've not been a skeptic, but you so desperately wanted to have contact with this lady. She's here. You or the family couldn't have done anything more for me. Right up until the day of her begravening, you could not have done anything more. I heard you talking to me. And in many ways, you look very much like her. Understand? And she's saying, but I came back. I walked across that bridge. And the thing that was so easy for me to come back is the love. Not that I just had for you, but the love you had for her. And that was a love from... She was an angel.
Yes.
And that's how I'm going to describe her. She was an angel. You've done nothing wrong. You did nothing wrong. And one of the reasons she came is to help you with this feeling of guilt that you have, that you didn't do enough. You understand? he wants to say this. That's how you show your emotion. Don't be afraid of that. It's a beautiful thing. You've gone away quietly and you didn't tell anybody and you said, Mama, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Mama whispered, I can hear you. I can hear you. Because you've had two women here. The one that I just started describing in the kitchen. The lady that's come now for you. Let's see what else Mama wants to say to you. As my spirit was leaving the body, I heard your voice calling. Do you understand? I heard your voice calling. These are the words that she will take with her forever. Do you want to hear it? Mama, jag älskar dig. Mama, jag älskar dig. As she crossed that bridge and she went to the spirit world, those words are right there. And Mama tells me there's a birthday coming up in September. You can check that out with the family later. There's a birthday coming. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
But you're hopeless at remembering birthdays, aren't you?
Yeah.
Ask her. She remembers.
Okay.
Good. Now we've got to go out again for a moment.
Men tydligen har Stefans mamma något mer att berätta.
Go back to your mama now. She wants you to know that in the spirit world, she has this most beautiful garden. There's flowers everywhere. And for her, she's now in paradise. She's holding a baby or a child that was a girl. But this young girl too wishes to say hello to you. Do you understand her? Do you understand Mama holding a child, a girl? She's fine with me. She's fine with me. Okay, I'm looking after her, okay? And there wasn't anything you could have done to save her either. Do you understand? So when the girl left her body, Mama was waiting. She was there to collect her. And there's the girl, she's happy, she's fine. It's almost like there's such a strong urge. I want to lean forward and kiss you on the cheek and give you a hug, but I can't do that because you can't do that on camera. But that's what this little girl wants to do. Mama's taking good care of me. Okay. Mama's taking good care of me. So the little girl should be coming back, sitting on your lap, snuggling up to you. Understand?
Yes.
She loves you. Mama tells me that the day this little girl passed, there was something very significant about the time that she's showing me, because I'm seeing the time on the clock about 20 minutes to 11. Mm. You recognize that?
I think so, yeah.
That's either when you got the news or when she passed.
Jag kommer tillbaka om några veckor och ser hur ni har haft det.
Ja, jättebra.
Okej.
Mm. Hej då.
Hej då.
Hej då.